Hi viewers, welcome to my channel Satya Sparkles. This segment is the part 4 of my capsule title, All That Glitters Is Gold If Your Mind Believes So. The title for this segment is Ego. Is it an asset or liability on the path to success? Growth is a fundamental phenomenon governing our life. We all want to grow, isn't it? It's a basic desire. We stand still, we go backwards in life. Simply put, there are three stages of growth: where we are, where we want to grow, and how to get there. Even more powerful question that we should ask ourselves now and then is, are we going in the right direction in our life? If the answer is either yes or no, what is one of the major contributory factors? Is it ego? Surprisingly, the answer again, perhaps, is yes and no. Let's explore more on the topic from multiple angles. All of us renew many documents and processes such as passport, driving license, insurance, online subscriptions, and many more periodically. Do we renew ourselves periodically, if not on a daily basis? Self-renewal is a principle and a process for upward spiral of growth and change of continuous improvement in our life. Agree. Then, what is the role of ego in renewing ourselves? Spirituality and Vedic scriptures define ego as a concept of I. You know, we say, I have told you, I am worried now, I got a job, etc. What we mean by mentioning I is the expression of the term ego. Yet, we are often told by others that we should shed our ego. Is it a paradox? We'll see some interesting examples from the history, assuming these occurrences were real. Even otherwise, it should be fine, I suppose, to consider these stories from learning perspective. The story goes like this. Julius Caesar was kidnapped when he was a young boy and held ransom for 11,000 gold pieces. Yet, he asked the captors to raise the ransom to 2,50,000 gold pieces in order to sustain his royal status and prestige. And we all know that July month with 31 days was named after Julius. Subsequently, when Augustus, who was also called egotist, assumed throne, insisted that the following month, that is August, named after him, should not have the number of days, anything less than 31 days. And hence, we know that only July and August are the two consecutive months in the calendar with 31 days back to back. So let's differentiate between ego and egotism. All of us should have ego, without which we cannot achieve anything in life. This means that if our concept or our understanding about ourselves, which can also be referred as self-esteem, is strong realistically, then we tend to have a healthy and strong sense of ego. For example, if you think that you are a competent doctor or an efficient professional in any field for that matter, this ego should help you to potentially succeed in life. Contrary to this attitude, if you think that you're the best person in the respective field, you tend to be egoistic. It is said that a popular wrestler once refused to tighten his seatbelt aboard a plane. He said, "A Superman doesn't need a seatbelt at all." The air hostess politely replied, "A Superman does not need a plane either." Egoistic mind hides the ego-driven thoughts such as superiority or inferiority complex, pride, insecurity, weakness, or limitations beneath the surface. The egoistic person craving to get noticed wishes to be a bride or a bridegroom when attending a marriage function. The person may also wish to be a corpse when attending a funeral function. In this case, the mind is preoccupied with spotlight syndrome, craving for constant attention and recognition from others. The "it is all about me" approach comes from the elevated ego, and it is so subjective. By understanding how the ego gets inflated in our mind, it is possible to create a balanced view and thus a purpose. In order to find your purpose, identify your passion as a first step. Your passion can be a driving force to love what you do. So have passion, not be passionate. Have emotions, not be emotional. Have sentiments, not be sentimental. Once you keep everything in moderation or follow the middle path approach, which is also referred as Buddha nature, life becomes very beautiful. Consider having learning or continuous learning as a powerful value system in your life. In other words, stay a student always. As the saying goes, live as though you are going to die tomorrow and learn as though you are going to live forever. Success breeds arrogance often in the minds of egoistic person. The person becomes defensive and fails to acknowledge contribution of others in his or her success journey. By seeing how the ego is prone to exaggerate its successes, practicing humility becomes possible. Humility is a strange thing. The moment you think that you have got it, you have lost it. Humility makes you resilient. Remember, grass can withstand storms, whereas trees get uprooted. So keep that egg ego in check to demonstrate humility through your words and actions. Colin Powell, the great military leader and the ex-secretary of the United States, says that in the military, when you become a four-star general, people will do anything you even suggest you want. If you say a wall looks a little dirty, by sundown it is painted. Never let your ego get so close to your position. When your position goes off, your ego goes with it as well. It is not just our own successes that sometimes inflate our ego. People surrounding you may flatter you and over-exaggerate efficiency of your strategy, knowledge, and talents for their undue advantage. It is better to be watchful to deal with such situations and to avoid getting trapped. Are you surrounded by yes people most of the time? Be aware. Human tendency in general is to think or talk about the past glory. Indeed, all of us should be proud to share his good memories of the past, achievements and accomplishments, as these boost our morale, increase self-confidence, and intrinsically motivate us to move forward in life enthusiastically and to seek social approval positively. But the flip side is that overindulgence with such repeated thoughts gradually become dominant thoughts. Unconsciously, like inflated balloon, resulting in egoistic nature. So, don't get stuck in the past. Keep moving and adapt to new situations always. In the words of Patanjali through Yoga Sutras, Asmita means I am-ness. It is having a distorted image about ourselves, which is not in sync with reality. It is either egotism or insecurity, the forms of egoistic delusion. They do not represent the truth that we are no better or worse than anyone else. The ego loves to win. Fame and authority naturally come to those who excel in certain domains. An insecure ego is terrified of losing control. When it is threatened, Asmita races to defend it. A healthy ego feels content and does not feel threatened. So, to avoid getting trapped in this delusion, we should consciously remind ourselves that we are no better than others and give credit to those who helped or supported us. If a man wants to acquire dignity, he has to only shrink or enlarge his ego to match self space. The story unfolds this way. A crow was carrying a piece of meat. The other birds flying in the sky started chasing the crow and attempting to snatch the meat piece. In the process, the crow got badly hurt. After having a serious thought, the crow dropped the meat and all the other birds started flying towards the falling meat. The crow realized that though it lost the piece of meat, it gained the freedom to fly in the sky fearlessly. So reflect on your dominant thoughts as a discipline. Check for ego quotient and drop the egoistic piece of the meat to attain freedom in life. Coming back to the title of the chapter, it is always our conscious choice to consider our ego as an asset or liability. So, healthy ego is the key to unlock our potential. So, if you like this segment, please subscribe, share, like, comment, and press the bell button. Thanks for watching. See you soon in my next video. In the meantime, this is Satya signing off. Goodbye.